A patient and two staff from Box Hill Hospital are tonight at the centre of a concerning new coronavirus outbreak. Let's go live to Reid Butler. Reid, health chiefs are moving quickly to keep a lid on this.
And they need to, Pete. We know how quickly health clusters can spread. The three confirmed cases have led authorities to urgently conduct contact tracing tonight. We know that two of those cases were included in yesterday's figures and the third was included in today's infection numbers. So it is now officially an outbreak. Parts of the hospital are currently closed for deep cleaning and staff in close contacts are being isolated and tested. The department has just sent through a statement. It reads that the source of acquisition is currently unconfirmed. However, all avenues of transmission will be investigated. So essentially, it is unclear how or why this outbreak has occurred. Very concerning for everyone here at the hospital, and it is very important it is contained quickly. The Peninsula Health outbreak in Frankston in early September totaled 80 cases, and Pete, no one wants a repeat of that.
Absolutely not. Thank you, Reid Butler. The cluster at Kilmore has grown, with a second staff member at the Oddfellows Cafe testing positive. It was one of 11 new infections today, as the Premier warns mystery cases could pose the biggest barrier to easing restrictions. Andrew Lund reports.
More queues in Kilmore today as testing uncovered another case linked to the Oddfellows Cafe.
The two staff members that had contact with the man from Melbourne have both been tested positive.
177 customers and their families have been told to isolate and get tested.
My sister ate in there on Thursday, and we've had close contact with her since then. So we've been advised to come down and probably isolate for 14 days.
I am still angry about it, especially because so many people have been affected by it, like the whole town has been affected.
The Kilmore infection is one of 11 new positive cases in Victoria, including three more linked to the Frankston cluster and one in Mildura.
We have a high degree of confidence that that will be a false positive.
With one case reclassified, the state's total has increased by 10 to 20,247. There are currently 203 active cases in Victoria, with 17 people in hospital. Melbourne's rolling 14-day average number is edging closer to the target of 5, now at 9.7.
In some ways, I'm a little bit less worried about that figure than I am about the unknown source cases.
Authorities want no more than 5 mystery cases in a 14-day period before Melbourne's restrictions are eased. Since September 30, there have been 6. The two most recent are in Dandenong and Altona North, with 4 others in Blackburn, Wyndham, Moreland and Maribyrnong.
Mystery cases are the key at the moment.
The government's now started asymptomatic saliva testing of staff at high-risk workplaces, such as this chicken processing plant near Bendigo, while new contact tracing software is also being rolled out.
It's being tested and ramped up to make sure it does what it's meant to do. And so far, we're pleased with it.
The Premier was today at pains to make clear he's aware of the toll Melbourne's lockdown is taking.
I've not seen my mother since Christmas. That's not good for her. It's not good for me and my kids and our family. I get it at a very deeply personal level.
And amid uncertainty about when the city will take its next step out of lockdown, Daniel Andrews offered some reassurance about the target date of October 19.
I think it is highly unlikely that nothing will change. There will be some changes. The exact nature of those we will need to look at.
Changes in regional Victoria are also being considered. Andrew Lund, Nine News.